welcome to a new episode of the podcast. I am joined by
Ellis
and Kieran.
And today we are going to talk about the post-COVID bucket list. First, we'll be discussing the topic of socializing in 2021.
God, I really miss socializing in real life instead of, well, apart from virtual cameras as we are speaking.
No, I completely agree with that. Like, I miss just sitting with my friends, literally doing nothing, just like talking and spending time, because virtually it's nice, virtually it's lovely to see people, but in real life it's just very different, and I miss it the most out of everything I've missed throughout this entire pandemic has been socializing with my friends.
Yeah, I mean, once of course if me and you see again, Milo, and you, Kenneth, we probably just want to hug after all that, because it was like a really stressful year. And even it is still kind of a bit stressful, but the worst is coming to the end, like, which is we hope.
We hope, that's the key word there. Hope.
Yeah. So of course, as the predict, all of this thing might be over at the summer and said we're not going to use face masks during summer, but I'm going to bring my face mask with me just in case. But, of course, now we're just here to talk about socializing. So, what's the thing we want to do while we're socializing in real life?
Definitely going to the cinema. I haven't been to the cinema in over a year and a half now.
I agree. I miss going to the cinema, feeling this epic sound, comfortable seat, put my handful of popcorn into my mouth while watching probably those superheroes movies or something action packed or whatsoever.
Honestly, at this point, I miss the cinema so much I don't even care what movie I'm going to see. I just want to go to the cinema. I just want to get like sit there and just, as you said, enjoy the surround sound and just relax and just watch something on a big screen. That's all I would want.
I told everyone I met, soon as cinemas reopen, I don't care what movie I'm going to watch. I'm going to watch one movie after the other. I'm going to spend an entire day in the cinema. And I'm also going to go down to the bowling alley. They put new stuff in it last year, made a whole thing new, and you get fast food ordered onto the thing. I don't care. I'll play bowling until by next fortnight.
I mean, of course, if we are going to win, just a fun day out for all the crew here. We're probably going to go bowling after all that. We do miss, of course, education, like seeing the teachers and getting some physical learning instead of being our wounds and learning.
Yeah, I'm currently doing a performing arts course. I've learned that doing a performing arts course over using Teams, is very, very, very difficult because a lot of it is very physical. It's about acting, it's about learning facial, how to act and dance. It's all kind of very hard to emulate virtually. So I've ended up just essentially sitting in front of a screen doing nothing most of the time. And it's sad because I really enjoyed performing arts for the first couple of months. And I still enjoy it. I miss doing it in person.
And one thing great for education is meeting other students and socializing, and you're also making friends out of them. I mean, it's kind of like a part of education is teamwork and making friends out of it.
Oh yeah, like in education, I've made some of the best friends I'll ever make.
Yeah, I mean, it is definitely important. And of course, any clubs you miss, you guys? Like any clubs you really miss socializing?
I used to go to a lot of clubs, especially this one. Usually takes me out of the house and does occupy my week, but it's kind of reduced to a 1080p screen in my parents' bedroom by looking at all our people through it. I think it's not as fun as it used to be, and it gets to a lot of people, and it's not right. It's not right. Everybody's like this in a way. I mean, we should be here for each other, and we should try and keep in contact, even though on the screen it's hard to keep contact because you can't help. But feel disconnected to someone on the screen. Because you can't care for people you meet. So that's why you should always try and drop in an occasional text to a person that you haven't seen in a while.
Is there any else you want to go, anywhere probably due to our possibility of limits traveling routes right now.
If I could choose to go to any country like post COVID, I really want to go to Greece. I've always the one country in the world that I always wanted to visit. I've never visited. So post COVID, I'm definitely going to try and book a trip to Greece.
What about you, Canis?
Probably Belfast. I mean, I stayed down there for a few nights. It'll be nice. It'll be a change of pace. I did it before, like a few years ago. It was fun back then, so it'll be fun to rekindle some memories.
Yeah, I mean, I probably want to do a little safe traveling while COVID is coming down. Like, we don't know, like, any other countries still have it, but still managing it. Like, but, of course, I probably want to go to Belfast first. Then, once I have enough courage to go somewhere else, like, over the seas, probably London or anywhere in the world, probably.
I'm also really excited about being able to like essentially just leave the house and not be worried about getting COVID. Because like honestly, like being stuck in the house for like months at a time has probably been genuinely one of the hardest parts of 2020 for me. Because obviously I'm used to like even simply like going to places like just around and just meeting with friends in different cities. That was probably one of the most difficult things for me. Like, what about you guys? Is there anything like local travelling you've missed?
Well, I will say I kind of do miss going to the town. I mean, it's kind of the only place I always go to. And I do want to travel a bit far, like to Belfast or, you know, probably Dublin or somewhere. But it's just the whole, like, I need to get my conference back after all this happened. Like, you don't know what's the safe place now after all this.
What about you, Kenneth? Any place you must travel in locally?
We did originally have plans to go Tenerife. Well, last year we were supposed to go on a holiday, but that was cancelled due to COVID and we weren't ready to risk it. It just didn't work right. But honestly, I wouldn't mind just going traveling back to Belfast for a night or two. I mean, anywhere in Dublin or anywhere different, really. Just someone to break the routine.
One of the things that I've missed probably the most throughout 2020 was like the thing like the arts, like travel, going to see like musicals and plays, because that was genuinely one of my favorite things to do. Going to gigs and like watching people and listening to like live music. The lack of that in my life was actually quite sad, because it's just something I really enjoy. So what about you guys? Have you missed anything?
There were a lot of damage on art. Even though right now, after hearing all the news, I feel like I want to support more of the local arts right now. Like, if there's any musical that's coming to Derry, I'm going there. If there's a play, I'm going there. Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And even live gigs or even like stand-ups or actual music or whatever, we kind of need to support them after all this. And I do kind of miss like the socializing of it too. Having a laugh with other people, and you never know, you have to socialize with them later.
Yeah, I completely agree. Like the there's a very distinctive link between like I've met a lot of my friends through the arts, through different through going to shows, and I've met so many fantastic people, and it's just slightly sad that we're losing that because of COVID. But I know, like, as you said, as soon as COVID goes away, I am diving straight back into the arts. I really want that connection and to support local artists and support plays and local playwrights and all that. I'm very excited. So what about you, Camus?
A few times in my life, I did went to Millennium Forum one for like a Comic-Con kind of thing, convention, and the other was like this pure funny guy called Farmer Michael. He did a stand-up comedy show. That is what I really enjoy. That was missing in my life. When I should have went to more comedy shows on down the Millennium Forum when I had the chance.
Yeah, so there's the concern about it is people are comfortable to go back to see all that again. If there's like a small number, it's kind of sad. But you just kind of want to bring life back to it, the type of thing. It is going to be, like, hard for arts and fielders as well, for us trying to like get back out there as well.
Oh yeah, like there's so many people who are terrified to go into like smaller spaces because of like COVID being like air transmitted and stuff, because the arts tend to be in like small and close spaces. A lot of people are just terrified. But I just cannot wait for the arts to come back, because I'm just, my heart's in it, and I just really want the arts to come back. Well, to conclude, 2020 wasn't the best year, to say the least. But 2021 has a glimmer of hope as we enter the spring period, because everything's going to, it's not going to be like an overnight thing, of course, but it'll be just glorious when we come out of this, and the world will be hopefully a slightly better place. So how are we all feeling compared to, like, we'll say like 3 months ago? Do we feel any better about the state of the world then?
I will say it was like still kind of felt a bit down during like going Christmas and of course today, but I mean, we already got the vaccine and we're getting shots, but I will say while we're seeing like glimmer of hope in the future, like we're seeing the brightness of it right now. Like the path of the darkness is kind of coming to the end.
Gotta say, it has been, I mean, 2020 did hit hard a bit for everyone, and they kind of followed everyone towards 2021. I gotta say, I'm personally feeling better now a bit. Yeah, not too bad as back then, but I think it does get better over time. That's all you can hope for. And I say, just keep your head up. You never know when the next thing comes around the corner.
Well, thank you all for listening to the podcast. Don't forget to tune in the next time.